Julian Ray is reporting live from Austin's streets. We're on Colorado and, say, 6th Street here, and there's a news crew set up. Something's happened. There are multiple officers that came in a hurry.
Okay. I'm like, thank you. I'm like, oh my God.
What happened?
All we know is just a shooting.
Not a standout for anything. It's all done.
Don't much. Waiting on the PIO.
That's not where you sit. Yeah, those are not lying, Austin. Pretty bad. But they got something going on down there. I'll come back for the PIO. Forensics. Forensics moving in now. There's some kind of shooting.
They're walking sleeping bags?
Yeah.
Some kind of shooting.
What?
I don't know. Ask the police. They're not talking to us. They don't have to respond to our questions.
No, that's great.
Fire's up a little bit. So she came in at 2:50.
Did they tell you what happened yet? You all right?
Good.
How long has that been going on?
Google it. It's all over the news.
Well, I mean, I've been watching the Steelers game.
Yeah. Well, please tell us what's going on. They just said it was a shooting.
That's crazy. In the middle of the day.
Yeah.
Oh. Shooting?
Yes, I can't say anything.
Oh, you can't. So where did you hear that from?
You can watch the news at have a lot
of stuff. News at 5, he's saying.
That's crazy.
What's crazy is that they don't have to tell us. That's what's crazy.
Well, it's always been that way.
I guess if you can get paid to do nothing, why not do nothing?
Like, they're getting paid to show up and film.
And to shut up. And to shut up. Hush money. See, I'm not supposed to be here.
How come?
Because the press isn't here.
No.
Press is supposed to go huddle over there and wait for information.
Who's that? You're the press. You should be able to do whatever the fuck you want.
I know, but I'm the street press. I'm with the challenger, so I do whatever I want.
Exactly. How's it going, man?
Hey, you too, man.
Hey, do you know what happened there?
Some kind of shooting. They're not talking to the press yet. So press is supposed to be waiting over there where y'all saw me earlier at the corner. Why wait? Let's find out what happened. Let's get some video of it. It matters.
Wow.
All you get video on the news is like the PIO's face. That's no good. How's that news? That's why Alex Jones and Univision don't want to interview me, because I keep telling them I'm going to talk about how you guys are not doing your job.
Odd time of day for a shooting, too.
Yeah, what the hell?
Yeah, transit police are here.
There's a lot of officers.
There is a lot, and there's a lot more over where you saw earlier. There's a lot. So something happened, and...
Was there an ambulance?
I don't know, I didn't see a single ambulance go by, all I saw was cops. That's what worries me. There's the scene. There's the cars. There's the commotion. There's been a shooting of some kind over here. What are we gonna do? Austin.
Footman drains, aluminum alloy body, even smarter with automatic emergency brake equal and efficient engine lineup, including the first ever F-150 power stroke diesel.
Let's make a lot of people happy. Hey, listen, I want to be the first to congratulate you and
get the bullet get their bullet pins.
No, please. People do not realize how special this young man is.
Good news for the police when there's a shooting of any kind, because it lets them amp up and purchase more revenue and expenses for growth and equipment and training to militarize even further. So it's always good news for the police when there's a shooting. I didn't even know this place was, they're hiring. This is the Austin Ale House. They are hiring here, it says. Apparently it's all over Google what happened. However, I'm not on Google right now, and I'm not really a watcher of other people's news. A lot of it's gonna be irrelevant. Is wiring him up for sound. They're all able to, all the media is trusted to go over there and touch the acting chief. Wonder if I can go touch him. Probably scared of me. Because none of these people have a family member killed by the Austin Police Department like I have. Most of these people are psychophants. Not an investigative reporter among them. They're just basically repeating whatever's told to them, which is usually a lie. Always promoting deception, APD. This one is behind me. Both my hands are filled with cameras.
Good afternoon. We're here to give a briefing on an incident that occurred in the 500 block of Lavaca today. This incident began earlier this afternoon at Barton Creek Mall. Austin police officers were dispatched to the mall at noon to handle a shoplifter at the mall. Our officers made an arrest of an individual at the mall, and we could not identify this individual. We did not have ID on him, and they were trying to figure out who he was. Through investigation, they came up with a name that they believed he might have been, and this individual had several felony warrants. For that purposes, he was placed in the back seat of one of our patrol cars, handcuffed under arrest, and a second officer followed in another police vehicle to bring him down to headquarters so we could try and positively identify through fingerprinting who this individual was. During that transport, when they were stopped in the 500 block of Lavaca, a conversation occurred between the individual we had arrested and the officer that was transporting him. The individual in the back seat was discussing suicidal ideations. The officer inquired whether he had the means. The individual stated that he did, and then removed a pistol, it appears, from the back of his waistband, placed it towards his head while still handcuffed. He was able to pull his hands around to the side, place it to his head. At this point, our officer announced, obviously, over the radio that the individual was armed, exited the police vehicle very quickly, started giving commands. Another officer did the same. We had multiple officers responding to this scene. This was occurring right outside of a bar that was crowded with patrons watching a football game at this time. So the officers were trying to get people a safe distance away from the scene while actively handling what was happening. Approximately 6 minutes pass with the individual constantly placing the pistol to his head. This is all on video. And then after approximately 6 minutes, the individual fires one shot, appears to strike him in the head. And then at this point, our officers form a plan to go up and extract him from the vehicle so they can begin to render medical aid. EMS was called to the scene. The individual was treated as quickly as possible here at the scene, loaded up and transported to Brackenridge Hospital. He is currently in Brackenridge Hospital in life-threatening condition at this time. We do not have an identification on this individual yet. Appears to be a young male, probably late teens, if not early 20s. But again, beyond that, we do not have an identification on who he is. Our officers that were involved in this incident, the officer that had him in the back seat of the car has been with our department just short of 11 years. And then the officer that was following him has been with the department for just short of 7 years. So again, the incident that occurred here on Lavaca is the culmination of an arrest that was made out at Barton Creek Mall. This entire incident is captured on the in-car camera system. And obviously, you see all the investigation is taking place. We will have an internal affairs investigation being conducted by our internal affairs division. We've got our special investigations unit. This is classified as an in-custody death, so there is a high-level investigation we will do into this incident. Obviously, if this becomes a death, it's an in-custody death. If not, it's a serious injury, and that's how we're working. So, again, early into the investigation, I will again emphasize the entire incident is captured on video, and it's very apparent. If you have any questions, I'll take them at this time. That's part of the ongoing investigation.
No police fired any shots?
No, there were no shots fired by the police. He was actually under arrest at the mall, both for shoplifting and for possession of a controlled substance.
Was the crisis intervention team responded? Did they respond to this?
I don't know if they were on scene.
Can you say what substance was arrested?
I don't know. I just know that when they arrested him at the jail, they arrested him both for shoplifting and possession of a controlled substance.
That question.
On video, it appears as though he's pulling it from his back, the small of his back to the right side of his back. And then again, he was handcuffed through this entire incident, but he was able to work his arms around his right side and actually get his hands to make contact with his head with the weapon.
Was there a danger to the officer inside the car?
Absolutely, there was a danger. If this individual had chosen to remove that weapon and fire at the officer instead without saying something, we could be here discussing a very different incident here.
Can we talk about normal procedure? I mean, normal procedure outside of this, do we search people when we put them in a car? I mean, is that something that normally happens?
Absolutely.
Okay. Any other questions?
So you guys saw what I saw. It's all on video. Starts with the handcuff. Starts with minor shoplifting charge. They don't want to see a person that owns the property. They have the right to, like, basically there was a guy that was shot and killed here. There was a guy shot and killed here at Frank and Angie's Pizza just a few months back, and they said he was looking in car windows, and so they started attacking him, and then he shot an officer after he was tackled by several people, including a security guard, including concierge, including APD officer. Yeah, it's unclear by Acevedo's statement which one it was. There's at least two people that tackled him, including APD officer, and he did not de-escalate. There was no crisis intervention done, and the guy ended up shooting the officer in self-defense because he felt that he was in danger of his rights and his freedoms and his health, and that he thought he might be killed by this officer who was tackling him because he was probably mentally ill or possibly mentally ill. And they would not bring out the crisis intervention team. Instead, they just did a field execution. That's in this case, it's different. The man supposedly, allegedly, on video, allegedly executed himself. Allegedly executed himself in the back of a police car here for simple misdemeanor, but he had some felony warrants. He didn't want to go back to jail. So can you blame him? Maybe the system's all wrong. Maybe the system's not working. Maybe the system has criminalized civil issues. Yeah, you can look that one up. It's on my videos too. I did the I was here for that one. And yeah. And this time the cops have an airtight alibi, but they don't really have an excuse for why they didn't check the man for a gun, why they didn't check his mental capacities to make sure he wasn't mentally ill. Maybe the whole system's wrong. Maybe it doesn't need to incarcerate people for petty theft and civil issues. You know, I mean, you look at how much that mall generates. Greedy bastards want to put people in jail for stealing a little bit of their bullshit. It's just wrong. You guys may not agree, and I don't really care, but there's more than just black and white. There's more than just we can either arrest people or let them steal. There's all sorts of help that can be given to this young man, who's apparently dead now, in the back seat of a police car. That's why they were putting the bullet tips in the back of the car, and they barely used any of them. That's where it went down. Apparently they brought him from the mall. This is the way to go to, one of the ways you can go to the jail. This is one of the routes that they go to the jail. They come up Lavaca, turn over there into the jail complex, and then go on through the big green doors. So, there's been a shooting. Man is dead. Police were involved, but it's just an in-custody death. And it'll be handled as such. Stupid cops. The whole policing system needs to be just gotten rid of. It's not working. It's not working at all for me. But for that young man. I feel that we live in dark times, guys. Really dark times. And I don't know what to say, but we live in really dark times. Really, really dark times. Y'all be safe. Love you guys. Here's your unmarked. One. Brown in color, Ford. Two, black in color, Ford. Black in color, Ford. There's your unmarked, the command vehicle here. We need to check this one on our records. Different command vehicle right there.
Liz Lee, activist lizard. Namaste, y'all. Be safe. Film the police.